My people in my health, and I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault. And that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Tonight, we begin Week 8 with a good matchup for you here between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a man drafted in the 3rd round in 2019 from West Virginia. It's Will Greer.
And he ought to have a lot of pep in his step after last week's performance because he did exactly as you want him to play if you're a coach. 3 touchdown passes, 0 interceptions, which usually means you're making a lot of right decisions out there.
And got him the win. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down. And here now the offense for Carolina.
And congratulations on their win last week, but they didn't get a whole lot of time to celebrate it on Sunday. They were right back to work on Monday, but you'll have to do things differently when you prepare for a Thursday night game. Because normally you'll take some time off. Here you get right back to work, work on the game plan mentally, and probably not put any pads on until you play again Thursday night.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Greer looks to throw. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now 4th down. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Winston and the Bucs take over now 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line. A big hitter there. A 1st down gain of 26 yards.
But he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Now a deep ball there on 2nd down, but it'll wind up incomplete. And now on 3rd down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the 1st. Now Winston. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 25-yard line. On 1st and 10, Winston. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's 2nd down. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. They'll throw again. Winston. He'll find Miller. That's complete. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Scott Miller, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
three and out.
And now
they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run with Henry. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Throwing on third down, Greer. He dumps it off for Henry. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. Derrick Henry looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. On second down now, it's Henry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Credit the sack to Vita Vea. On now, Graham Gano. He's hit from 63 as recently as last year. Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Spinning away.
They don't want it, boys. They don't want it. They don't want it.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have to be thrilled with that first drive. They got him the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Trey Boston shot through on the safety blitz for the sack.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line, Brian Burns. He's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here. Back-to-back sacks. Third and long for Winston.
The competition comes up.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And they're going to be set up in the red zone at the 15. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
And he's got the hook up to Moore. 12 yards that time for number 12 as they move the chains.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered,
can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
They'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
While you admire anyone trying to pick up an additional couple of yards, they're just not worth it when you take shots like that. Quarterbacks have to stay in the game and stay on the field.
Looking to throw again on second down. Greer, under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. Four sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
Now, that's something of a pick-me-up, but the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put three on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
The lead cut to just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. This one taken from the 7. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Kareem Hunt and the rest of the offense making their way back out there. Those are his numbers through roughly the first half of the season, and given that, you'd have to think he's on pace for a 1,000-yard campaign.
Steady as he goes, steady goes the offense, but you know what else is happening too, because they are a team now recognized with the ability to run the football. You've got to be able to throw better now, right? Better throwing lanes, better opportunities for the guys downfield, maybe more one-on-one coverage, which you should be able to beat easier. Yeah, he's establishing not just a tone, but an identity for his team.
And that's a discussion we had a couple days ago in the team meetings, talking about this running game opening up the passing game. We'll see if that continues to happen. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. A first down run, not going to get him a whole lot. Maybe a yard. Yeah, it looks like just 1 yard there. So that'll bring up second and 9. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll try to throw now. Winston. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 21. Winston now to throw on first down. And this will be broken up and incomplete. Now a penalty flag down. And they may be going backward here. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against him.
Jameis to throw it. He finds his tight end, Howard. That's complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
What we got? What we got? What we got? Easy. Mike, 50, 50,
50, 50. On third down, here's Hunt. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. Winston to throw for it on fourth. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt, and the Panthers will get the football back. 13 seconds, the time remaining in the half as they come up on first down. They're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. From the nine, here's second and nine. And he's going to lose yardage here back at the eight. So we've reached intermission here. Well, why don't we hold off on the halftime update after all? Seems like everyone's ready to go here for the second half in week eight in the NFL.
Let's go, boys. Bring it up.
So here are the Bucs to take over on offense. They've won two straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Hunt. In on the tackle there, Luke Kuechly.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks, just like a quarterback would on offense to get him into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal game.
On third down, Hunt. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Now we're going to get a timeout. Here's we've got an injured Buccaneer. We'll check on his status when we get back. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on fourth down. They'll go with Jones. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen.
Offside defense.
Yeah, that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not, it's not the misses, it's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
A good pickup there, a 22. Now a first down carry by Jones. He's got the first down inside the 10. And all the way down to the 5.
Here we go. Here we go.
That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Now Jones. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. Second and goal from the 6 this time. Now Winston. That's caught by Howard. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. They get only a yard there. Now it's 3rd and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans, his 5th touchdown now on the year as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter, out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
5 plays there on that drive. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. This is taken at the 3. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why?
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Carl Nassib able to record his 5th sack of the season.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now whistles, flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. Not a great start to this drive. You had the sack, now the false start.
I mean, it doesn't take much to either read lips or just imagine what the head coach is saying right now. Get your head in the game, guys. Let's go.
Here's Greer now on 2nd down. That's complete to the Memphis man, Anthony Miller. It'll be a 20-yard gain on the play, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Greer on 3rd down, and that will be incomplete. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. To throw is Winston. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
5 on the 50. Winston from the gun on 3rd down. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. He's picked off at his own 47. 2-score game here in the 4th, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a 2-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on it and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion, we can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
And the first play of the drive there is incomplete. An incomplete pass on 1st down, that leads to a 2nd and 10. 2nd and 10, here's Greer again. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 14 yards, good for a Panther 1st down. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Greer on 1st down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Marquise Lee, the intended target, but it'll be 2nd down. 2nd and 10 from the 33-yard line. On 2nd and 10, Greer over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 21. Greer now, 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Henry out of the pistol. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. On second and 11 now. Greer under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Devin White in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. First and second down were a disaster. Both went backwards. Now it's 3rd and 18. They need something big. Greer. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first. But at least it's 4th down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
And there's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3 and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
This one taken from the 7. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Right now clinging to a 1-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that 4-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays, they're going to gain yardage, how would you say it, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs, and the goal, end the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
He finds his target. It's Evans. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Winston. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. We've got a 1-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Winston here to throw, letting one go, and this is caught, and that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face, and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So now the Panthers down by 15. At time, a huge factor. Their offense has struggled all night, and now they need to find 2 scores late to try to pull this thing out. Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a 1st down. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Back to throw, Greer. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore. And now it's second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. Greer sets to throw and caught by Henry. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Greer looks to throw. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock.
Come on, set. 60 out, Law.
Yo, 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 yo. Yo.
Ready?
On third and long, here is Greer. He finds his man, the tight end Olsen. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 12-yard line. Greer in the offense with a first and 10, and he's 5-for-6 now throwing the ball on this drive. So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And it was their defense that led the way, allowing just 3 points that lone field goal in the entire second half.
And remember the old adage, offense sells tickets. Defense does what?
Wins championships.
And in this game, maybe a championship wasn't won, but a game was by the defense, right? Held them in just a field goal? That's a heck of a job. I mean, when they went out there with that determination and a pretty good game plan,
It took me so long.